Good morning, children. How are you? Hope all of you are well and enjoying this online studies. So, what we have done yesterday? Yes, we have learned in networking concepts the types of network. So, today in the recap of the chapter, we will continue with few question answers. So, let's start. The first question is, differentiate between LAN and WAN. So we have to write the difference between LAN and WAN. So how we write the difference? We have to draw a line in the between, and at one side we will write RAN and at the other side we will write WAN. So the first point in LAN is it stands for local area network. And the first point in WAN is it stands for wide area network. Now the second point in LAN is a computer network that covers a small geographic area such as home, office or a school. So yesterday I told you this, that LAN is a network that connects the computer within a small geographic area, like within a building, within a home, within office, we connect our computers, then that network is called LAN. And the second point in WAN is a computer network that covers a broad geographical area, like such as cities, states and nations. So we can connect the countries using the WAN. We can connect one computer in India with another computer in America using the WAN. Now the third point in LAN is, in LAN computers are physically connected with wires. So when we use the LAN, when we connect computers within a building, then we use wires. But in WAN, computers are connected using communication facilities like telecommunication or satellite signals. So WAN can be wireless as well. And in LAN, we use wires. Now this is the difference between LAN and WAN. Now see the next question. Now the second question is, what do you understand by network security? Means when we are using networking, when we are connecting our computer with other computer, then what is network security? So let's see the answer. The answer is, network security means protecting data and resources from unauthorized access. Unauthorized access means anyone who is not authorized, who does not have rights to access the data, who does not have rights to see and use our data, he should not be able to open our data and resources. So we have to protect our data from him. So network security means we are protecting our data from anyone who does not have right to open our data. So network security means protecting data and resources from unauthorized person, from unauthorized access. It is the most important aspect in computer networking, since many users are accessing the same data. So we must ensure its proper security. We must ensure that anyone should not be able to open our data. Everyone should not be able to see our data, to use our data. Only authorized person should use it and open it. Now, only authorized person can access and modify our data. If anyone is not authorized, if anyone does not have the right to use our data, then he should not be able to use it. So this is called network security. Now the third question is, explain client-server network. What is client-server network? So let's see the answer. Answer is, client-server network is a network where several computers called clients or workstation are connected to the main computer called the server. Means here there is a single computer which works as a server. He is serving everyone. He is giving the service to everyone. And the other computers, which are called clients, they are accessing the services from the server. They are connected to the main computer called the server. So A server is a computer that provides services to the clients and control access to hardware, software and other resources. So what is a server? Server is the central and main computer who is providing services to everyone. And who is client? Clients are computer which request services like data retrieval and storage etc. from the server. So clients are the other computers which are requesting for the service from the server. They are asking for data, they are asking for storage, and server is providing the services to the clients. It is giving them hardware resources, software resources, and it has the control of all the things. This you can understand using the example of teacher and a student. A teacher is a server who is at the center and who is providing services to every student, and all the students are client. You can see in this picture, at the center you can see there is a server, and the server is providing services to every computer, and these computers are called the clients. So this is client-server network. So I hope these three questions are clear to you. Now in homework, you have to learn and write these questions in your copy. So this much for today. Thank you.